Hello friends and students. Today in this video I am going to share another beauty of infinite sequences. I would discuss nature of sequences expressed in recursive form. So to begin, let us first understand what are the sequences. So let us first understand what is a real sequence. A real sequence is nothing but a function from domain N to a set A, where A is a subset of set of real numbers. Let me again clarify that I am talking about real sequences. For example, let us consider the function f from domain N to codomain, let us say, close interval 0, 1, such that f of N equals 1 upon N. Here, if we put the values of N, which are natural numbers, as N equals 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on and so forth, we will get the outputs as 1, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 1 over 4, and so on. For a general input, say N, the corresponding output is 1 over N. We simply represent the sequence as 1 over N. Now I come to the main form of the sequence, which is recursive form. A sequence Xn is said to be represented in the recursive form if the later terms, or say Xn plus 1, is expressed in terms of Xn, or as a function of Xn. In some cases, we get the recursive form as Xn plus 2 being represented in terms of previous two terms. For example, the sequence Xn equals 1 over N can be expressed in the recursive form as Xn plus 1 equals Xn over 1 plus Xn, where the first term of the sequence being 1. Now here, in this expression, if we put the value of N as 1, we get x2 equals x1 over 1 plus x1. Now if we put the value of x1 here, x1 is 1, so we get 1 over 2, which is the second term of the sequence. If we again put the value of N as 3, as 2, then we get x3 as x2 over 1 plus x2, and the value of x2 is 1 over 2, and putting the value of x2 here, we get 1 over 2 over 1 plus 1 over 2. It gives us 1 over 2 over 3 over 2, which is 1 over 3. We can verify that the sequence 1 over N can be expressed recursively in this format. Let us have a look at some other examples. In the second example, if we take x1 equals 2, then the corresponding sequence is 2, 1 over 2, 2, 1 over 2, and so on. Clearly, this sequence oscillates between 1 over 2 and 2 and does not converge. in the example 3, if we take x1 equals say root 2, then this is a well-known sequence, root 2, square root of 2 root 2, and so on. And this sequence converges to the limit 2. In the third case, if we take x1 equals 1, then we get the sequence, the constant sequence 1, 1, 1, and so on, which is again convergent to the limit 1. Let's have a relook at what we have done so far in this video. First of all, we define the sequence as a function from set of natural numbers to a set which is a subset of set of real numbers. Then we defined the recursive form of a sequence. Now let us come to the most important and the most beautiful aspect, which is the geometrical aspect of the recursive form of the sequences. Suppose we have a sequence xn plus 1 as a function of xn. That is, we have a sequence in recursive form. Now, what we can do here is let us plot the function y equals fx. Suppose that the function y equals fx is something like this, and also plot the line y equals x. So here this line is y equals x and this curve is y equals fx. Let me explain more clearly what I am doing here. First, I am replacing xn with x, and xn plus 1 with y, and I am getting function y equals fx. So first I am plotting this y equals fx with x and y axes. And then I am also plotting this line y equals x. Now with this arrangement, if we put x1 in place of x in fx, then y will give us the value of x2. Or I can alternatively state it as, if I take some value x1 on the x-axis, then corresponding to the function y equals fx, the corresponding output on the y-axis will be x2. So this will be x2 on the y-axis. Now, what is the role of this line y equals x here? We know that the x and y coordinates at every point on this line are same. So at this point where this line parallel to x-axis intersects the line y equals x, the corresponding point on the x-axis will be x2. I hope you get my point here. What I am doing here, I am taking x1 somewhere on the x-axis and I go to the function y equals fx. Then I can directly reach the line y equals x, and where it intersects the line y equals x, I again drop a perpendicular on x-axis to get x2. Now, similarly, if we start with x2, I can get x3. What will be the procedure? the procedure will be almost the same. From x2, I have to first reach the function y equals fx, then I have to reach the line y equals x, and directly coming back to the x-axis, I will get x3. Or on the y-axis, I can represent x3 also. Similarly, from x3, we can get x4. What will we have to do? First, we have to reach to the curve from x3, moving parallel to the y-axis. Then, the point at which this line intersects the curve y equals fx, from that point, we have to move parallel to the x-axis until we reach or we intersect the line y equals x. And then, from that point of intersection, we have to draw perpendicular on the x-axis to get x4. Now, from this observation, we can easily see that for this particular sequence, xn plus 1 equals fxn, x4 is less than x3, x3 is less than x2, x2 is less than x1, when we are taking x1 here. Now, if we continue this trend, it means that the sequence is monotonically decreasing as each new term is smaller than the previous term. And also, these terms of the sequence are tending towards a fixed point, and that point is the point of intersection of the line y equals x and the function and the curve y equals fx. If we drop this point here, this point is L, suppose this point is L, then x1, x2, x3, x4 and so on, these terms are tending towards L. Now, let us take x1 positive, but towards the left side of L. Suppose we take x1 here, and then we want to determine the other terms of the sequence, then what will we have to do? We have to first move parallel to the y-axis until we reach the curve y equals fx. Then the point where it intersects the curve y equals fx, from there we have to reach the line y equals x, moving parallel to the x-axis, and then again dropping a perpendicular on the x-axis to get x2. Now, from x2 we can get x3, from x3 we can get x4, and so on and so forth. From here we observe that if x1 is positive but towards the left side of L, then the nature of the sequence is monotonically increasing, as x1 is smaller than x2, x2 is smaller than x3, and so on and so forth. But again, the terms of the sequence are tending towards L. So in both the cases, the sequence xn converges to the limit L. One very important case is when we take x1 equals L, then x2, x3, all the terms are equal to L, and then the sequence is a constant sequence. Now we will see some other examples that we discussed earlier. The first example was xn equals 1 upon n. And the corresponding recursive form was xn plus 1 equals xn over 1 plus xn with x1 equals 1. Now, if we write the corresponding function y equals fx, then the function is y equals fx equals x over 1 plus x. If we plot this function, we get something like this curve. If we are taking x1 as 1, then the corresponding x2 will be, we will have to draw this line parallel to y-axis, and then again moving towards the line y equals x, and then coming back. This is 1/2. This is 1/2. So we are getting very good result here. X1 is here, x1 is 1, and x2 is 1/2. Now if we want to find x3, then again from x2 we will reach the curve, and then from the point of intersection we will reach the line y equals x, and again from that point of intersection we reach the curve and also the x-axis. This gives us 1/3, which is x3. Similarly, from this point we get 1/4, the next term, and so on. And all these terms are really tending towards L equals 0, which is again the point of intersection of the line y equals x and the corresponding curve y equals x over 1 plus x. Here I would like to remind you all that our sequence was xn equals 1/n. And as n tends to infinity, this 1/n tends to 0, and we are getting exactly the same result, or we are really representing the same result geometrically here, that all these terms are 1, 1/2, 1/3, then 1/4, 1/5, 1/6, and eventually they are tending towards L equals 0. So this is the beautiful result or beautiful explanation of the concept of convergence geometrically. In the next video, I will be sharing with you all some other examples, and also I would discuss some more important results that can be explained geometrically, like boundedness of the sequence. This is all for this video. Please share, subscribe, and like for the upcoming videos. Thanks for watching.